Are we on?
We're on.
Hey, cool. Okay, so tonight we have this tiny little fly. The new petri dishes. Look at that. Snazzy. We got very clear. We're going to have a fun act of getting the spider from our spice jar here into the petri dish here underneath the microscope so that she can feed and have a new home. Just figuring out how to get both in without losing one in the living room. So first we're gonna, and she's very active. First we're gonna try and move her. You know, we learned that Western Lynx spiders can jump. I don't really feel like having her jump out at me. Okay, plastic wrap is off. I'm not really sure what kind of a fly this is. Let's see if she wants to come out here. So I have her kind of upside down on this petri dish here, which I would really like her to get it completely upside down, but she's built some nice webbing. Let's see how we're going to do this. Let's make sure we've got the right lid. There should be a top. And there's a bottom. Now here we've got, let's zoom out here, the layout of our workstation here. As best as I can go, you've got the spider in the upper jar. You've got the little fly on the petri dish bottom. And now I've got to get, oh, well, let's take a look at that, because she is, that was a little faster than I expected. She's grabbed her prey. Now I've got to get her out of one. There. Okay, so let's see how she got that. She was so fast. That here in her claws. Good evening. She knows there's a way out here. Flip her maybe. So it's better for seeing. And let's try to get her into some sort of viewing for you. We can see, change some of the lighting here. Move her around just a little bit so she's in your view. You can see in her mouth. That little fly did not last long. Whoop. It's okay. There we go. Territory. There she is. Here's her. She doesn't want to cooperate. See, she's got a little web following her, a little piece of silk. Let's see if she wants to stay there to eat. She's on the go again tonight. A meal on the go. I don't know what kind of fly she ate. And my observation is, for such a live creature, these petri dishes are a little bit big to follow around. Especially when we want to see our beautiful little spider here. What do we have here? It's okay lighting. There we go. So she stays. I gotta move her without her being angry while we're moving her. There we go. Get to focus. Oh, you can see the little bug underneath her is still moving just a bit. She's fully, she's a very well fed spider. Such a tiny little fly. There she is. Oops, I'll go this way with our zoom. And our focus. Good evening, dear. And underneath her are the antennae from some sort of little tiny fly that I found just outside the windowsill. She was quite hungry. She jumped on him rather quickly. See if I can get her on a different angle here. Now that she's eating. Nope, she doesn't want to play. I didn't measure the fly, but I think the fly was probably about 1 millimeter. If that, it was very small. Let's go with a grain of salt. If that, I think that might have even been bigger. It's kind of like those annoying tiny little fruit flies that bother you. Three red dots on the fly, kind of like on the back, the crown. You saw the two eyes, and then you had these three little dots. It had kind of a clear looking body to it. As well. Where is she here? There she is. Let's see where she wants to eat. She's put some, she's just got some silk webs around. It's kind of like living in an empty room. We haven't given her any furniture. There she is, with her hairy legs. She's got these long hairs, we said, that help her detect tiny vibrations. And right here, so you can see on the fly, oh, let's bring it back into focus a little bit, that she is munching on. You can see his eye. It might have actually been four dots on its head at this bottom corner, or down to the bottom there somewhere. You can see its eye. Its head is moving up, and its antennas right beside it. And she's got him in her grip. Very opportunistic. Three red dots. Very opportunistic feeders. Just did not waste any time. Oops. Let's see if I can get this into focus a little bit more. Those are those red dots. There's its eye. She's going to liquefy him or her for dinner and drink it She loaded up a straw. Some digestive enzymes. Going on right behind, I would really like to see upside down what's going on, because you could see more of the angle. Let's see if I can get this on an angle so that you can kind of see underneath. Zoom out here, a little bit more in focus. Ever so slightly. I don't think we'll see much of that angle. Not what I was hoping for. Oh, maybe. Kind of balanced here. Let me zoom in. Focus here a little bit. Reflection from the lights. She knows exactly where to hide so that we can't see much. There's a bit of an angle we have around. There's our eye. You can see the eyes on the fly here. You can see also just below the eyes, those clear marble looking things. She has her, the spider has her claws also holding on, like a cat holds on to a mouse. Let's see, I took a couple of pictures of the fly. Let's see if we can get those into our stream in a second here while we watch. Here. It's really fascinating to watch. I'm just like, you know, you can watch a nature show and feels like really prepared. This is really, it was so, oh, you can see how she's pumping the abdomen there full. On the spot. I'm gonna do it again. Let's see, in the top right corner there, it's like a full little balloon. And twist her a little bit. Okay, let me look at something here under the eyepiece. And we're going to look to see if we can see here. We're going to look to see if she will allow us to go underneath her or find a better angle for her. What's really amazing is that through the eyepiece, you really get more of a three-dimensional image of the spider than you do, for instance, when she's on the screen. But the screen does give you a pretty good view of what we see inside. Where did she go? Very fast. Inside the eyepiece. When I look at the eyepiece, I also see that not only is she fast, she has running behind her silk coming from her lower abdomen that she is dragging behind her and kind of making some structures for her to climb on and give her more grip. Let's see if I can flip her again. And if those structures allow her to be very fast when we flip, she's also just as fast. And so let's see. Oh, there we go. You can see these white little lines coming from behind her here. Those are silk threads. You can see them more clearly now. She is quasi-weaving and getting trapped in a little bit. Kind of wrap around her. Let's focus in on those silk threads for you. See, there they are, those threads all around. And she still has her little fly in her mouth. I just have the feeling that she's looking right at us with those two upper eyes. And now she's moving him around a little bit. Let's see if we can. There's a wing. She's really crumpled his little wing. Here. There. Just nibbling. And there's our fly. There's the wing of the fly below. Now we had a plant that we took from a local park. We went on a walk and it's pretty little plant. I believe it's called Sweet Allison. And when we looked under the microscope, we saw these tiny, tiny little bugs. And then they were multiplying. You could see on the first day there was maybe one or two that we could find, and then we found a whole bunch more. And it turns out those are thrips. Now we've got house plants, and thrips are very invasive, so everyone who lives here thought it would be a good idea to put the thrips plant in with Rachna and have her clear the plant of the thrips, because Western Lynx spiders do eat thrips. So that might be an idea now that we have a slightly larger petri dish. Wouldn't mind sealing off the petri dish after though, because I do like our house plants. Even though half the time I forget that they exist. They've had thrips before and it's a pain to get rid of them. There she's dropped him. There is not much left of our friend fly here. He's got some shriveled up leaves, or some wings, sorry. Doesn't look very pretty anymore. Not that he was very pretty to begin with. And there he is. No longer of interest to Rachna. Those are those nice silk threads that she has from behind her. Sorry about my finger. And she's very fast. Very fast. And apparently the little fly does not take as long to feed as a book lice. She took the book lice for probably, pardon me, half an hour or so. I don't know how long this has been, but she's definitely a lot faster. And eating the fly. It's a much smaller fly. And there's our fly. In a second, I'll just load that. So you can see. She sits there so calmly. Waiting for the action to happen. Let's see. You have a lot of specimens here in our bag full of collecting things. I can take out the first bag. Let's see if I can put them both in there. What do you think? Good idea. Now the thrips are so small. Oh, there's our fly. This is the fly that she ate. Tiny little guy. He was going Professor Fly. Those look like little sunglasses or little glasses on him. He was not very fast. It was actually rather easy for me to catch him. And even easier for our friend. This is with the different light on the fly. You can kind of see his insides a little bit more. Very clear on the inside. Those are those three dots on his head. Clear eyes. And clear wings. Nice photo that we took. I'm glad we had, because she was too fast for us to put them into focus together. There he is. I think we'll post that picture on iNaturalist and find out what kind of fly that is that we fed to Rancho tonight. Because that would be interesting to know what she likes to eat. So, then we'll, let's see how she does with the thrips flower. Kind of don't like putting my whole hand in the bag now that it's full. That one's close. Also, a couple of days, I'm just going to move right out of the way. A couple of days ago, these little thrips were so small that you couldn't see them with the naked eye. And now you can kind of see little tiny critters walking around here under a microscope. Let's see if we can go to the next dream in a second. They're in a plastic bag, a little Ziploc bag, so we get more advanced in our collection. methods. Let's see if we can zoom out and find one here. It's also kind of been in the bag for a couple of days. There it is. Let's see if I can find my finger. Around here. There's a little tiny, yeah, thrips here. We did that little thrips that looks like one. That ring thing. And so we'll find out how big that is. Have a little measuring tool. This is very cool. See, it's the best way to do this. First, we have to find it again. There it is. In the middle here. It didn't squish it. There it is. We have this tool. Let's say maybe he's about 0.6 millimeters. Maybe 0.6 millimeters. Is the thrips? That's a bit too big otherwise. That is very tiny. It looks big under here, but that is, if I zoom out a little bit more, that is really, really tiny. In comparison, that's my fingernail beside it. It's not very big. Put a little measuring tool back. Very cool little tool. We will put back so it doesn't break. And we will, I think tomorrow, find a way to move our thrips plant into Rachna's new home, and that'll be like furnishing it with some IKEA furniture. But tonight we must go to bed a little bit earlier and feeding our new pet spider pollen. So it might be that we have a name for our fly. Could be that it is a Trichosocus clarus. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, but they can be found on the West Coast and all around the United States and the United Kingdom. The Azores, Canary Islands, and Finland and Europe as well. The species are either yellow or orange. They're basically found globally, but we found ours on the West Coast. Do we know more, a little bit more about it? Are they? That looks like our friend fly. It must be what it is. Once we confirm that, I believe it is. I'd say that's pretty close to what we have for our fly. And then tomorrow we'll be feeding Rachna, wherever she is here, some thrips.